हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द टुडेज लेक्चर। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ बैक्टीरिया। ओके, सो बैक्टीरिया क्लासिफिकेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वी क्लासिफाई बैक्टीरिया ऑन वेरियस बेसिस। ओके, लाइक साइज, शेप एज वेल एज स्टेनिंग, एंड दे आर सो मेनी मेथड्स ऑन विच वी आर क्लासिफाइंग दैम ऑन डिफरेंट क्लासेज। ओके, इस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द हाउ टू क्लासिफाई बैक्टीरिया ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ शेप। Okay, now just look at here, we are dividing bacteria on the basis of their shapes. Okay, so just look at here, we have a cocci, then bacilli, and then other shapes. Okay, so how we remember these three terms, cocci, bacilli, and other shapes? So we have a one trick to remember this. Just remember our trick, our punchline, that is O, B, and C. We know other backward classes. This is our category. Okay, one category. So O for other shapes, B for bacilli, and C for cocci. So by this OBC term, we can remember these three different type of shapes. Okay, so cocci are monococcus, diplococcus, streptococcus, tetracoccus, and cluster shape, octet, and kidney shape. Cocci is basically what we can say, it is a oval shape, berry shape, as well as spherical shape. Okay, so how are different cocci? Just look at here, monococcus, diplococcus, and streptococcus. So if they are oval shape, so just look at here, the first, what is our example? Monococcus. So monococcus is basically, just look at here, this is a monococcus. Okay, just look at here, this is a, suppose this is a shape of bacteria, and this is, we can say this is a monococcus. Okay, and then similarly, so monococcus, the example of monococcus is Micrococcus flavus. It is an example of this class of bacteria. Okay, then we have a diplococcus. So what happened in diplococcus, just look at here, suppose this kind of two balls, okay, two balls are attached with each other, then it will called as a diplococcus. Okay, so just look at it, diplococcus. So diplococcus pneumoniae is another example. Then streptococcus, so streptococcus is what, basically it is a chain like structure, it is a chain like of a single, like multiple monococcus if attached, then we can say it is a streptococcus. Okay, so basically streptococcus, in this we have an example of Streptococcus pyogenes. Okay, clear. And then tetracoccus, we have a these four spherical kind of shapes are attached with each other, then this is known as a tetracoccus. Okay, just look at this here, if these all four oval shape are balls are connected with each other or attached with each other, then it is known as a tetrad. Okay, so example of tetracoccus is Giefka tetrazena. Okay, Giefka tetrazena is a example. Okay, now just look at here, the cluster shape basically they are irregular shape, or they may be a grapes shape. Okay, so in cluster there are so many balls are connected with each other. Okay, so the example of cluster shape is Staphylococcus. Clear. Then octet, so just look at here, what is octet? Basically we can say these are four and four, eight balls if are connected with in this shape, then we can say this is a octet. And suppose if back to back they are connected, then we can also say this is a octet. Okay, so this is the example of octet. Sarsinia is the example of octet. Okay, and then we have a like kidney shape bacteria. So example is gonococcus. So just remember this. So examples are very important in the case of shapes. So many time examiner asks about the shapes of various bacteria. Okay, so on streptococcus, strep means basically a chain. Okay, so you can remember by this way. And the our trick to learn these are basically what, this is one, and this is two, and this is a long chain. Okay, and then this is a four, and then this is a eight. So 1 2 4 8, the trick is 1 2 4 8, and then the multiple cluster we have, then it is like 16, 32, and 64. So So just remember by this way 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. Okay. So 1 means monococcus, 2 means diplococcus, and tetrad means tetracoccus, and 8 means octet. Okay, then example of 8 is Arsenia. So remember by these examples. Then just look on the bacilli. Bacilli we are calling them as a rods. Okay. So bacilli are what? They are chain shape, and then as well as Chinese letter shape, or we can say that the another name of Chinese letter is basically a cuneiform. Then palisade pattern, branch pattern, or filamentous, as well as pleomorphic, and then diplobacillus and coco bacillus. Okay, so chain again similar to here. Okay, streptococcus, and here example is bacillus anthracis, but the shape is rod shape. Here the shape is basically a rod shape. So chain is another example, Chinese letter. Just look at here the Chinese language. So this is just looking like V, but various different shapes we have in this Chinese letter, or we can say cuneiform. So the example of Chinese letter or cuneiform is Cornibacterium diphtheri. Okay. Then palisade pattern. So this is another example of palisade pattern. This is the way they are connected with each other. Okay. So just look at here. This is the way they are connected with each other. Okay. So just look at, just consider it as a rod. Okay. So just look at here. Similarly, if we are connecting each other by this way, then this could be considered as a palisade pattern. So the example of palisade pattern is diphtheroids. Okay. Then branch. So this is just look at here. These are the branch of rods. Okay. So the example is Nocardia and Actinomyces. Okay. And then pleomorphic. Pleomorphic means various type of shapes. They can change the shapes, and multiple kind of shapes they have. So the example of pleomorphic is Proteus and Haemophilus. Okay. Proteus and Haemophilus. Then just look at this. This is the shape. Okay. This is the shape. Clear? These are the various shape. And diplobacillus. Diplobacillus means two. Diplo means two. And bacillus. Bacillus means rod. Means two rods. So just look at here. These are the two rods in these. And cocobacillus. Basically, bacillus rod is basically a cocci type. Okay. So that's why we are calling it as a cocobacillus. So just remember how we can remember it. Like pleomorphic, examples of pleomorphic, how we can remember them. So just remember our trick. The example is pH. Our trick is what? pH. Okay. So P for pleomorphic, P for Proteus, and H for Haemophilus. Okay. So many time examiner asks in the examiner this kind of questions. Okay. Then just look at other shapes what we have. So these other shapes are basically what we have, coma shapes. The example of coma shape is Vibrio cholera. So many times examiner asks these questions. So look at this. I am showing you the coma shape. So just look at here. This is the coma shapes. Okay. This is the shape of Vibrio cholera. Okay. Now just look at another bacteria that having a different kind of shape like thumb print. So this is our thumb, and if we are putting our print by putting ink over here and then putting here, then we can find the thumb print. Okay. So Bordetella pertussis is the example. So you can learn it by TB. Okay. Our trick to learn is basically TB. Okay. Tuberculosis is the disease. So you can remember thumb print, Bordetella pertussis, T for thumb print and B for Bordetella pertussis. Then spirally coiled. Okay. So this is the shape, how they are spirally coiled. Okay. And then just look at it. Spirochetes. Spirochetes is the example. So remember spy and spy. Our trick to remember is spiral. Okay. Spiral and spiro. Okay. So both the words are similar. So this is the way we can remember this. Then gullwing shape as well as curve shape. Both are basically similar shape, but sometime examiner asks on the question on the which of the following bacteria is gull wing shape. So student do not remember this. So curve shape and gullwing shape, almost they are almost similar. So just remember, gullwing shape is basically a curved shape. Okay, so example is Campylobacter and Helicobacter. Okay, so remember, this Helicobacter is the bacteria which can cause ulcer, H. pylori. Okay, and bacteria that lack the cell wall, okay, so the example of that bacteria is Mycoplasma. Okay, so Mycoplasma, if the bacteria do not have cell wall, they can vary their shape. Okay, so the example of that bacteria is Mycoplasma. Remember this, the examiner always asks the question on this. Then look at the other shapes. Okay, so this is the other shape, is basically a box shape bacteria, and the example is Arcula. So sometime examiner asks question, which of the following bacteria is box shape? So Arcula is the example in this category. Okay everyone.
Hello everyone, now just looking on the question. Question number 1, Vibrio cholera bacteria shape is A. coma shape, B. box shape, C. cluster shape, and D. thumbprint. Okay. Question number 2, spirally coiled bacteria is A. Bordetella pertussis, B. spirochetes, C. campylobacter, and D. gonococcus. Question number 3, which of the following bacteria having Chinese letter shape? A. Bordetella pertussis, B. spirochetes, C. Cornibacterium diphtheri, and D. gonococcus. Question number 4, which of the following bacteria having cluster shape? A. Bordetella pertussis, B. staphylococcus, C. Cornibacterium diphtheri, and D. gonococcus. Question number 5, which of the following bacteria having pleomorphic shape? A. proteus, B. haemophilus, C. both of these, and D. none of these. So I already given answer of all of these question in my lecture, so go through with the lecture and answer in comment box.
So I hope you are able to remember bacteria classification on the basis of their shapes. Here I discuss some question. You can give answer of these question in comment box, and like the video, share the video, and subscribe the channel. Now moving on different further cocci type and then bacilli type, and now moving on further cocci types. Okay,